The pretty girl. My cupcakes, darling, and welcome back to my channel. 6:53 and I don't have to be at work till 8:30. I just wanted to do a quick video, and this video is going to be, of course, if you already read the title, Dermablend versus Sacha Buttercup. I just want to see basically which one works best, and the plan is I'm going to have it on about all day at work, probably around till 10 at night tonight, because I have a class to go to and that lasts from 7 to 9. So I just want to see which one is better for the buck. The Sacha Buttercup, I believe, is $22 and the Dermablend is $27. Oh, if you like my eyes, I already did this look before, so I'll link the video right here. Okay, I'm gonna do my left eye with the Dermablend. Sacha Buttercup on my right eye. It is really soft. Not seeing it melt into my skin like Dermablend. Now I'm just gonna clean up my lines before I let it bake for 5 minutes. Yes, I know I did not bring concealer all the way down here on my cheeks and stuff. I don't know why I always bake like this, but I did. Now cupcakes, let's see what time it is. It is 6:58. At 7:03, I'll come back, swoop all this away, and we'll see. So I did come back a few minutes early because there's a few things I wanted to and forgot to mention, like how much product come in each. Sacha Buttercup comes 35 grams.
While the Dermablend comes 18 grams.
But they look like about the same size and stuff. Couldn't really tell. So you get more product for Sacha Buttercup, and obviously it's 22, so it's cheaper. Whereas you'll get less product for Dermablend. But yes, it's just easy to just, you know, just work. Yeah. Oh, this is easier to dust away. Sacha Buttercup is easier to dust away. And remember guys, I'm gonna have this on throughout the day, so I'm gonna check in and tell you guys how's last. Hopefully it doesn't make too much of a difference on both eyes, because like I said, I will be at work and then at this meeting tonight. So I guess if people do make comments, I could be like, you know, what for you too. But thanks people do for you too. Yes, I need my person to shine, baby. To me, it looks the same. I never have a problem at a Dermablend. So I am going to be curious to see how this Sacha is. All translucent powder, no matter what, no matter how much it costs. When it gets on your black, it messes. So you always gotta go in and get some like mascara and eyeliner. Now to set all this, oh shit, forgot to, you know, do my little foundation thing. I'm using my Mary Kay pressed powder with my Mary Kay brush. I like how it's sticking to that tart. Like, I think because of the tart, it's making it easier for me to put my foundation on. Sacha Buttercup. Dermablend. Sacha Buttercup. Dermablend. Comment below which one you like. So I'm off work. It's like 3:54, going on 4 o'clock or whatever. And I just wanted to do basically just a check-in to see how the Sacha Buttercup and the Dermablend, which one is winning. I haven't touched up my makeup, though I wanted to. I really did. Because, like, I'm sure you can see that little glowiness in my T-zone right there and on my cheeks. I did apply my lipstick once at work because my lips was like, I'm sure I pretty much bit off all the lipstick that was there. As you know, with liquid lipstick, your lips tend to get a bit dry. I just put some moisturizer on before I got on camera now, so it didn't look a hot mess. But while I talk to you guys, I am about to go in and do a touch up. Yes, baby, because I'm shining. And at least I did wait, right? Yeah, both of the powders, they both feel lightweight.
This is the Sacha Buttercup. Wonder if it's focusing. And this is the Dermablend. Do you notice any creasing or anything?
Oh, let's do a smell test. I didn't do that. Sacha Buttercup don't smell like anything. Dermablend has a little scent to it, like a perfume-ish smell. I kind of like it. It's not like too heavy. I promise you, I never noticed that scent up until I just smelled it now. So obviously, it gotta be like a lot of it together in order for you to smell it. Because without it, you didn't smell it. Not at all. Okay, so I'm back with my final thought. It's around 10 o'clock at night. And I just wanted to make sure I finished this video because I'm completely tired and so happy that I edit what I had earlier. As you can see, I'll let you be the judge of it. Let's see. Trying to let the camera focus. I don't know if it's really focusing. Of course, the Sacha Buttercup is darker and the Dermablend was lighter. Also, I wanted to say it rained all day, so I was in the rain with the both. I didn't touch up my makeup or anything. I did notice when I was doing some editing, the Sacha one, it settled in my lines. And right now, since it's so late and I've been having this makeup on since around 7 this morning. Of course, anybody will touch up and stuff, but I didn't do no touch ups underneath my eyes or nothing. So I'm gonna say between who I like more, Dermablend or Sacha Buttercup. Ding, 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 Dermablend. Dermablend wins, of course. I mean, look at that shit compared to this shit. I see way more lines right here. I see that 1, 2, like no. No, honey. This win. I mean, you may get only 18 grams of product, spend an extra $5 than the Sacha Buttercup. But come on now, be for real. This setting powder lasts you a good year or so. And then anybody that does makeup, of course, you alternate. You have
to. Well, honey. This one is my favorite.
Until next time, I wanna say thank you for taking your time out to watch my video. Give my video a thumbs up, and if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel. And if you won't, leave nice comments down below. Thank you. Bye-bye.